Benik Afobe, centre forward for Milton Keynes Dons.
Josh Waters, Tyco Suzuki Superbike rider.
Well, I started playing football when I was 5-6 years old in a local park in Essex, Dagenham, and I was one of the luckier ones. One day, an Arsenal scout was just at the park and he thought I had something different to the other boys, and I got scouted. And then, cut a long story short, I've been at Arsenal since I was 6, and here I am today, 21.
Yeah, I started riding a bike. I was lucky enough when I was 3, for Christmas, I received a Suzuki four-wheeler. And then I started racing when I was 4 on a little two-wheeler. Since then, my parents made a lot of sacrifices. I raced dirt bikes till I was 16, and then started out on the road. I was lucky enough to ride for Suzuki on the road for 7 years back home in Australia. And then they opened up a lot of doors for me. I got to race in a few big races in Japan, the Suzuka 8-hour for Suzuki, which was a great thing. And then that opened up doors to race in the biggest domestic championship in the world, which is the BSB. So I came over here. That was a real eye-opener, moving out of your home country. And yeah, I'm lucky enough my wife came with me. And then yeah, this year I joined back into the Suzuki family, so I've been really lucky for sure. Without my family making the sacrifices that they did over those years, it would have been really tough. So yeah, that's my story.
Like I said before, dedication, you know. When your fitness coaches, your manager, your parents, at a young age they tell you you've got to do this or you've got to go and run, you've got to do it. So I think, again, with that question, I think dedication. And there's going to be weeks and there's going to be days when your schedule's going to be harder than other days, but you just got to do it and you've got to get on. And to reach the top or to be professional, you've got to do it all. So I think after a game, normally training's a bit easier. You've got to ease yourself away back into it again. But then as the week goes on, you start doing more tactical work. And I think, as I said, I think they don't really kill us. You know, everyone thinks our footballer has to work hard or a sportsman has to work really hard, but they're not stupid. You know, these managers and these fitness coaches and the people that have seen it all, they ease you back into it slowly and gradually. And then once you get fitter and stronger, it gets harder, and all good things are hard. So I think it's fine when you're a sportsman. You don't mind doing it.
I think, like every sport, whatever sport you do, playing that sport is the best training or so. So, yeah, being a motorbike rider, riding a dirt bike, a road bike, is the best thing. But especially over here in England, it's a lot harder to. Back home in Australia, it's easier for me to go and ride my dirt bike. I could ride it every day of the week, especially where I live, because I live in the country. Right. So, no one gets angry if you. Making some noise, unless you're riding in the middle of the night or first thing in the morning, they're going to crack it. But main things I do is just cardio work. I do light boxing and a lot of stretching. So if you crash, you hopefully bend instead of braking. That's the biggest thing. Also, our races go for around 30 to 40 minutes. So I run and stuff like that. I don't run for 2 hours. I just go for a run for a half an hour or 45 minutes, try and do that. Like I said, stretching is the biggest thing. I've got a personal trainer. Mm-hmm. It's around an hour to an hour and a half sessions, and we just try and smash that out. The biggest thing for a bike racer is your brain. I experienced that last year. I came over on top of the world. I was so confident, and then I got brought back down to earth, and I had a bad year kind of thing last year. So this year it's just been building back up, and now I feel like I'm back to where I should be. And so much of it's your brain and believing in yourself that you have people telling you the right things, but it's in here if you don't believe. So
that's exactly like me. Everyone at MK Dons knows that I've been injured, and I've had my fair share of injuries, and as you said, this year it's been my first year where I think I'm back to where I was when I was 18, 19. I'm only 21 now. And whatever the physios can say, they can get you back sharp, they can get you back strong. Your manager can say you're the best player in the world or whatever. But if you don't believe it within yourself, you're not going to do it. So I think, as you said, as Joshua said, it's all mental strength. And if you've got a good head and good people around you, it makes your job and your work much easier. So I think mental strength is a big part, a very, very big part.
Like just before the race or the week leading up? The week leading up, I try and drink a lot of water, because that's one thing with bike racing, you're wearing a leather suit.
Yeah.
So even, it's okay here because the weather isn't as hot, but when it's in the middle of the summer, or one race I had to do earlier this year in Japan, it was 40 degrees and the humidity was 90%, so, and you're riding for an hour at a time, so you lose near 3 kilos in that hour. Yeah. Obviously, you know, you want to keep the fluids up.
Mm-hmm.
Just before I race though, I have a spin bike in the camper and I warm up on that for 15, 20 minutes, and then I have set out little thing of stretches I do, about 15 stretches, and I don't know whether it helps me or not, but I do them all the time.
Do all the season.
I think in my head, you know, if I've done those stretches, yeah, I'm going to be all right. How about yourself?
No, I'm not one to be superstitious or anything, so I always prepare the same Monday as I will on Saturday or Sunday.
Yeah.
Like, before training that, because of my injuries, I do my little warm-up and stuff, but before match day as well, I do the same things, you know. Just, for me personally, some players are different. They don't want to be spoke to, or they want to be in their zone, but I think for me, if I started to do that, I think I'll change my game. I'll think this is a big game, it's a big occasion, and then I'll probably get nervous, but I just take it as it is in training. And I think if you train the way you do on a match day, then it shouldn't be a difference anyway. Yeah. So for me, I'm not really superstitious. I just concentrate on playing well for myself and for my team. And if that happens, I don't think no one cares what you do before the
game. Yeah.
Diet is a big thing, and I think you, as you get older, you understand how important it is for a sportsman. When I was younger, I never used to eat bad, but I didn't think about the water, little things like that, and that's probably why I had injuries. So in a way, maybe my injuries was a blessing in disguise. Like now, even after training, I'm just drinking water. Even today, my fitness coach had a go at me because I said to him I had breakfast earlier than normal, so I was hungry, and he was angry at me for having it too early, my breakfast, even though it was a good breakfast, just for the fact he wants to have a good routine of having your porridge or whatever it is in the morning, so you're ready for training, and then after training you'll be hungry in time for when they give us lunch. So I think to be a top player or top sportsman in anything you're doing, you have to have a good nutrition, and you have to, because it's probably 2-3% difference, but that 2-3% will make you maybe a bit sharper, or it'll make you a bit, it'll open your mind to see things and do better. So I think it is important. It's not much of a difference, but the 2-3% is what makes you go from being good to great. So I think it is important.
Yeah, I think we have very similar, you know, looks on what we eat. With the bike racing, you want to try and be around, I want to try and be around no heavier than 72 kilos, because it means so much. So you don't want to go bulking up too much and stuff. So you eat the right foods to help there, especially on race day. I'm sure the same on game day.
Pretty
for yourself.
Stuff,
you don't want to be, you know, so you're feeling
so heavy,
so
stuff,
heavy and stuff. So yeah, very similar.
Yeah.
For myself, it was really special because at the start of the year, like I said earlier, I come back and I wasn't very confident.
Yeah.
And I was struggling to score points, let alone battle for wins in a race. So coming in when you have a bad result, you know the boys have tried their hardest, the whole team, and then you see the looks on their faces. But then at the end of the race, when I got to come in the pit lane and in the winner's circle and see the boys' faces, that was the best feeling. And then also, you know, stand on the podium listening to your national anthem with the crowd, it was pretty cool. But the main thing is the people that put in behind you, and you know that, seeing the looks on their faces,
you do it for them as well,
and they, you can tell that they honestly feel happy, you know.
That's the best feeling, like you just said then. Like my family, when you probably didn't have the greatest year, me, when I was injured, my family were always there, my mum, my dad, my older sister, they like support you, and when you get hurt or when things are not going well, it feels like it's them. So when you do great as well, they feel like they've won as well. So it's a fantastic feeling, and especially when no one or not many people believed in you, or things were looking like they were going down, and then for me, when I scored the two goals and we won the game, it felt like a relief, like finally something's going my way after you've been injured or when things haven't been going your way. But people look at that and they think that you're going to stop there, but if you want to be great, you want to continue and you want to keep doing well. You don't want it to be a fluke or one off, and that's what all the great sportsmen do, don't they? Personally, my ambition since I was 5-6 years old, I know you haven't got long, is to play in the Premiership and to play for England and to be the best player I can possibly be. So when I get to 27, 28, I still want to be improving. And that's me, playing the Premiership and play for England.
I'd love to race in the World Championships, like every rider's dream, to race with the best riders in the world. That'd be my dream.